Welcome back, students. In the chapter motion, we have already discussed about certain equations of motion, right? We have three equations of motion, that is v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, and v minus u square is equal to 2as, where v is the final velocity, u initial velocity, a the acceleration, t the time taken, and s the displacement. So these three equations of motion relate velocity, acceleration, and distance. So these are the three equations that relate velocity, distance, and acceleration. Now let us see how this equation of motion will change for a freely falling body. Already we know that the acceleration of a freely falling body is completely due to gravity. So let us observe how these equations will change for such bodies. Let us consider case 1 as when a body is dropped from a height. When a body is dropped from a certain height. For example, a ripened fruit falling off a tree is an example of a body which is dropped from a height. Okay, if in such a case, let us see how these equations of motion will modify. When a body is dropped from a, so initially the body was at a height, that means initial velocity of the body was zero. Since it was at rest, it was at a height in a rest position, the initial velocity of the body is 0 meter per second. Now the body is being dropped. That time here the body is in free fall, so acceleration of the body is acceleration due to gravity. Since the body is in free fall, the acceleration of the body is due to gravity, and the body is descending down. That means as the body descends down, the velocity of the body increases. As the body descends down, the velocity of the body increases. As a result, the acceleration due to gravity will have a positive value. Since the velocity is increasing as the body moves down, the acceleration due to gravity, g, will be having a positive value. Now, coming into our equations. So, we already have v is equal to u plus at. The equations are s is equal to ut plus half a t square, and v square minus u square is equal to 2as. These are the equations of motion when the body is under some external force. Now let us see how these equations of motion will change for a free fall. First equation becomes v is equal to u plus, since the body is under free fall, a is equal to acceleration due to gravity, and since the body is falling down, its velocity increases, and hence acceleration due to gravity will have a positive value. So instead of a, substitute gt. And in this case, in case 1, we know that u, the initial velocity, is 0 meter per second. So v becomes 0 plus gt. That is, equation become v is equal to gt. This is equation number 1. for the case when a body is dropped from a height. Now the second equation is s is equal to ut plus half at square. So s is equal to, again in this case u is 0, so u into t becomes 0 plus half. Instead of a, we know that a is equal to acceleration of the body is equal to acceleration due to gravity. So instead of a, we can substitute g into t square. So equation becomes s is equal to half g t square. This is the second equation of motion. Now the third equation of motion is v square minus u square. So v square minus, we know that in this case u is equal to 0 meter per second. So let us substitute that. V square minus, instead of u square, 0 is equal to 2 into, here instead of a we can substitute acceleration due to gravity, g into s. That is, equation gets reduced as v square is equal to 2gs. This is the third equation. So if the object is being dropped from a height, for example a fruit which is being dropped from a tree, in such situation the equations of motion are, the equations of motion are v is equal to gt, s is equal to half gt square, and v square is equal to 2gs, because the initial velocity of the body is 0, and here since the body is descending down, the velocity of the body will increase and hence the acceleration will have a positive value, and since it is a free fall, acceleration of the body is the acceleration due to gravity, and we get these equations. So these are the equations of motion in case 1. Hope it is clear. Now moving on to case 2. Case 2 is when a body is projected downwards, when a body is projected vertically downwards with some initial velocity. So a body is dropped from a height with some initial velocity. For example, a boy who is on the third floor of a building is dropping a ball vertically downwards with some initial velocity. Then how these equations of motion will change in this case? Okay, so here initial velocity is not equal to 0, because the object is dropped vertically downward with some initial velocity. So u is not equal to 0, and here too the body is moving down, the body is ascending downwards. So as the body moves downwards, the velocity of the body will increase, and hence its acceleration will have a positive value. Here also the body is under free fall, so acceleration will be equal to acceleration due to gravity, and it will have a positive sign, positive value, because the body is moving downwards. As the body moves down, the velocity of the body will increase, and hence the acceleration due to gravity will have a positive value. Now let us see how the equation of motion will change in this situation. Already we have equations of motions as v is equal to u plus at, s is equal to ut plus half at square, and v square minus u square is equal to 2as. These are our equations of motion. Now for free fall, the first equation becomes v is equal to u plus, instead of a we have acceleration due to gravity, gt. Second equation becomes s is equal to ut plus half, it is at square. So instead of a, acceleration of the body is acceleration due to gravity. So instead of a, substitute g into t square. Third equation becomes v square minus u square is equal to 2 into acceleration of the body is acceleration due to gravity, and it is having a positive sign. So 2 into g into s. So in this case, initial velocity is not equal to 0, acceleration of the body is acceleration due to gravity, and it is having a positive sign, since when the body descends down, the velocity increases and hence the acceleration due to gravity has positive sign. And substituting these values in these equations of motion, we get the equations of motion for a freely falling body as v is equal to u plus gt, s is equal to ut plus half gt square, and v square minus u square is equal to 2gs. Okay. Now moving on to the third case. A body is projected vertically upwards with some initial velocity. As you throw a ball upwards, that is this case, throwing a ball upwards, the body is thrown vertically upwards with some initial velocity. So in this situation also, the body is having some initial velocity, so u is not equal to 0. And in this case, the body is ascending upwards, the body is moving up. As a body moves upwards, its velocity will decrease. As a body moves upwards, its velocity will decrease, and hence its acceleration will have a negative sign. When a body moves upwards, its velocity will decrease and acceleration will have a negative sign. When a body moves downwards, its velocity will increase and acceleration due to gravity will have a positive sign. Since the body is under free fall, the acceleration of the body will be equal to acceleration due to gravity. But here the body is ascending upwards. When a body moves upwards, its velocity will decrease and hence acceleration due to gravity will have a negative value. So here A will be equal to minus G. Okay. Now let us see how the equations of motion will change. First equation of motion was V is equal to U plus AT. And this equation will change for a freely falling body moving upwards as V is equal to U plus, instead of A, it is minus G. So substitute minus G into T. That is V is equal to U. Plus into minus, it is minus U minus GT. So the equation becomes V is equal to U minus GT. When a body is projected vertically upwards. Second equation of motion is S is equal to UT plus half AT square. And it becomes as S is equal to ut plus half, it is a. Here acceleration of the body is equal to acceleration due to gravity, and it is having a negative sign since it is moving upwards. So instead of a, let us substitute minus g into t square. So equation becomes s is equal to ut plus into minus becomes minus half g t square, equation number 2. Now the third equation is v square minus u square is equal to 2as. That is v square minus u square is equal to 2 into, instead of a substitute minus g into s. So equation becomes v square minus u square is equal to minus 2gs. So these are the three equations of motion when a body is projected upwards. So when a body is projected upwards with some initial velocity, it is having an initial velocity u, and since body is moving upwards, it is ascending upwards, the velocity will decrease and hence acceleration will have a negative value. And since this is a free fall, acceleration will be equal to acceleration due to gravity, and it will be having a negative value. That is, a will be equal to minus g. And on substituting these values in the equations of motion, we get the equation of a motion of a freely falling body that is moving upwards as v is equal to u minus gt, s is equal to ut minus half gt square, and v square minus u square is equal to minus 2gs. Okay, so these are the three equations of motion in case of a freely falling body that is moving upward with some velocity. Hope the three cases are clear for everyone. So the points to be remembered is, in free fall, just substitute, instead of acceleration of body, just substitute acceleration due to gravity. The second point to be remembered is, if a body is moving downwards, acceleration due to gravity will be positive. And if body is moving upwards, acceleration due to gravity will be having negative sign. These are the two points to be remembered, and just substitute these values in your equations of motion that you have studied in the first chapter and get the equations. Okay. Now let us do some numerical problems to understand these equations more. First question is, for the question you can refer your NCERT science textbook. First question is there in your textbook, page number 136. You can take page number 136 of your NCERT science textbook. Question example 10.3. Example 10.3. And the question is, a car falls off a ledge and drops to the ground in 0.5 seconds. Take g is equal to 10 meter per second square. Subdivision 1, what is its speed on striking the ground? Subdivision 2, what is its average speed during 0.5 seconds? And subdivision 3, how high is the ledge from the ground? So this is the question. So let us, after reading the question, let us write the given quantities first. So here, a car falls off a ledge and drops to the ground in 0.5 seconds. So the time given is 0.5 seconds. In the question it is given, take g is equal to 10 meter per second square. So acceleration due to gravity, g is equal to 10 meter per second square. Subdivision 1 is, what is its speed on striking the ground? When an object falls down, what is its speed on striking ground? So, the initial velocity of the object is 0. In the first subdivision, we need to find V. Okay. So, here the object is falling down. Since the object is falling down, its velocity will increase as it descends. And the acceleration of the body will be equal to acceleration due to gravity, and it will be having a positive sign since the body is moving down. So, let us substitute the values. We need to find V. The equation to find V is equal to U plus GT. That is, V is equal to U is 0 plus G is given as 10 meter per second square, and G will have a positive value since the body is descending down, and T is 0.5. So, V, on simplifying it, you will get the answer as V is equal to 5 meter per second. V is equal to 5 meter per second. Now, subdivision 2 is, what is its average speed during 0.5 seconds? You need to calculate its average speed. To calculate average speed of a body, formula is U plus V by 2, which you have learnt in your first chapter motion. And here U is 0, V, we have already found the value of V as 5 meter per second divided by 2. 5 by 2 is 2.5 meter per second. So, this is the average speed of the body. Now, subdivision 3 is, how high is the ledge from the ground? How high means you need to find the height of the body or the distance. To find height or the distance, we have the formula S is equal to UT plus half GT square. Again, U is 0, T is 0.5 seconds plus half into G, value of G is 10, and it will have a positive sign because the body is descending down, and T square is 0.5 square. 0 into 0.5 is 0 plus half into 10 into 0.5 into 0.5 square is 0.5 into 0.5. On solving this, you will get the answer as S is equal to 1.25 meter. So, this is the height of the ledge from the ground, and S is equal to, you got the answer as S is equal to 1.25 meter, and you found it using the equation S is equal to UT plus half GT square. Hope the problem is clear. Now, moving on to the next question, again in on page number 136, example 10.3. Page 136, example 10.3. Making a correction, excuse me. The previous question that we discussed was example 2. Sorry. The previous question that we discussed was example 2. And now we are going to discuss example 3, which is there in the page number 136 of your textbook. And the question is, an object is thrown vertically upwards and rises to a height of 10 meter. Calculate, subdivision 1, the velocity with which the object was thrown upwards. Subdivision 2, the time taken by the object to reach the highest point. So, this is the equation. So, in this case, the object is thrown vertically upwards. It is moving upwards. The object is moving upwards to a height of 10 meters. So height is given as 10 meter. Height is given as 10 meter. And here the object is thrown vertically upwards. When an object moves upwards, its velocity will decrease. As an object ascends upward, its velocity will decrease and the acceleration of the body will be equal to acceleration due to gravity, and it will be having a negative sign. Since the body is ascending up, the acceleration due to gravity will have a negative sign, since the velocity of the body decreases as it ascends up. Okay. Now, subdivision 1 is calculate the velocity with which the object was thrown. So, you need to find the initial velocity, the velocity with which it was thrown. And here, the object is thrown vertically upwards. As the object moves up, its velocity will decrease. So, initially, the object had a velocity u, and when it moved up, the velocity will decrease, and finally, when it reaches a maximum height, when the body reaches a maximum height, the velocity will become 0 meter per second. So, initially the body was having a velocity u. As the body moves up, its velocity will start decreasing, and when it reaches a maximum height, its velocity will be approximately equal to 0 meter per second. So, here the final velocity will be 0 meter per second, because since the object is thrown to a height. So, we need to find u. So, the given quantities are S, A and V, and need to find u. And we may use the equation V square minus u square is equal to 2GS to find u. And here, by substituting the values, that is V square is 0 minus u square is equal to 2 into, here g is having a negative value, so minus g into s. That is minus u square is equal to 2 into minus, so minus 2gs. Minus sign and minus sign will be cancelled off. So u square is equal to 2 into value of g, acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 meter per second square. And height is given in the question as 10 meter. Height covered by the object is given as 10 meter. So, u square is equal to 2 into 9.8 into 10. You will get it as 196. So, u square is 196. Therefore, u will be square root of 196. On taking root, on simplifying it, you will get the answer as u is equal to 14 meter per second. By simplifying root 196, we will get the answer as u is equal to 14 meter per second. This is the answer for subdivision 1. And subdivision 2 is calculate the time taken by the object to reach the highest point. Now, in order to reach the highest point, what is the time taken? So, here we need to find the time taken to reach the highest point. So, when it reaches the highest point, the final velocity will be 0. We have already found the initial velocity as 14 meter per second. And we know that acceleration of the body is acceleration due to gravity. Acceleration of the body is acceleration due to gravity. And since the body is moving upwards, it will have a negative sign, which is equal to negative 9.8 meter per second square. So, here in this question, we have V, U and G values. and we need to calculate T. For calculating T, let us use the equation V is equal to U plus GT. Substitute the values. V is 0. U we have found it as 14 meter per second square plus value of G is 9.8, negative 9.8 into T. That is what we need to find. So 0 is equal to 14 minus 9.8 T. Now take this minus 9.8 T to the other side. So minus 9.8 T becomes positive 9.8 T is equal to 14. When negative sign moves to the left hand side, negative sign becomes positive. So it becomes 9.8 T is equal to 14. Now to solve T, T is already we have 14 here. Take this 9.8 to the other side. So here it was 9.8 into T. So when it moved to the other side, become divided by T. So T, divided by 9.8. So T is equal to 14 by 9.8. On dividing it, you will get the answer as T is equal to 1.4 seconds. On dividing and simplifying it, we will get the answer as T is equal to 1.4 seconds. Hope the problems are clear for you and the equations of motion have become crystal clear. Thank you.